A beginning is a very delicate time.
Hello, welcome to the channel. Today it's September 23rd, 2020, and the only reason I bring the date up is because a year ago today, we crossed 100 subscriber threshold. We were at 101. Today, at the time of this video, we're at 335. So hopefully today's the day you push that subscribe button. And don't forget, if you're watching the video, bitch slap that like button. Speaking of the video, ladies and gents, today we're going to be talking about Dune. Big shout out to the Fandom Collective. Hashtag rise together. So we're talking about Dune, but before this intro drags on any longer, monkeys, roll that footage. The monkeys are rolling the footage. They work slow in the morning.
Yeah, that works.
I like
all right.
That.
Okay. All right, moving on. Hey, what about?
Yes, Dune is a remake of the 1984 movie, and it's being modernized in multiple ways. This article by Ashley Broadwater. Let's dive into this, shall we? Dune is coming out this fall, which I don't know why they say fall. It's in December, which is not fall. That's smack dab in winter. Well, it's December 18th, so technically still 3 days left of fall, but let's not get bogged down in semantics here. Dune is coming out this fall, starring Zendaya and Timothée Chalamet. Although it's a remake of the 1984 film, the story is being updated, and by updated, they mean race and gender swaps. The 1984 version of this science fiction movie is based on the 1965 book series by Frank Herbert and features Kyle MacLachlan, Virginia Madsen, Sting, and more. The 1980s movie, directed by David Lynch, portrays a Duke's son, Paul Atreides MacLachlan, leading warriors against the Galactic Emperor and his father's enemy. Sounds suspiciously like Star Wars a little bit, doesn't it? Well, this book predates Star Wars, so. The synopsis of the Dune remake, however, is a little bit different. It's about noble son Paul Atreides being entrusted with the most valuable and crucial element in the galaxy. Of course, they're speaking of the spice. Chalamet will play Paul in the remake, setting out on a dangerous adventure to ensure the safety and future of his family and his people. In addition to stars like Zendaya and Chalamet, the stacked cast also includes Rebecca Ferguson, Jason Momoa, Dave Bautista. This really does have a great cast. They don't even mention Oscar Isaac or Stellan Skarsgård. What's better is the director, Denis Villeneuve, said he wants to split the movie into two parts since the books are so complex, which in the day and age of trilogies is amazing to hear. I'm only going to do two parts to this. That's great, honestly. I don't need a trilogy on everything. Not every movie needs a trilogy or even a sequel for that matter. This, however, needs a sequel definitely. He also says the remake will be nothing like the original, which Dune readers criticized heavily. The new will also expand upon some characters, like Lady Jessica, Paul's mother. In addition, Liet Kynes, an ecologist in the movie, will be portrayed by a woman of color. Just say black woman, it's okay, that's fine to say black woman, instead of a white man. Now, which it's funny that they make a point to say that, because it's kind of funny, like, you didn't have to race swap this character or gender swap it, but you did. I mean, it is what it is. I get it. It's okay. The author makes a bigger deal out of it. And I'm just pointing it out to you, because when I heard it, I was like, okay, well, let's go with it and see how it is. But I just, it's funny when they try to, an author who, it's hard to even call these people authors, makes such a big deal out of it. It's played by a woman of color. Like, oh my God, that's so stunning and brave. No, it's fine. It's fine. You have a black woman playing the role. Don't say a woman of color. Jesus. I mean, are we really that bogged? Is like saying black people or a black woman offensive? In addition, Liet Kynes, an ecologist in the movie, will be portrayed by a black woman instead of a white man. Villeneuve believes this coming-of-age movie functions as a call to action for humans need to adapt and stop exploiting resources. It tackles important issues like politics, religion, ecology, and spirituality. Now, if this is strictly Villeneuve's take on this, okay. The only thing I have to say is I don't want another Avatar, which is basically like capitalism and industrialization bad, tree-hugging hippies and blue smurfs good. You know what I mean? Like, I'm excited about this movie. I just don't want to be preached to. You know, you can put messaging in there. That's fine. Every movie has some degree of that. I'm just saying, don't let your message that is not central to the theme of the movie outweigh the theme of the movie. You understand what I'm saying? So what do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below. Please be sure to bitch slap that like button for me. And like I said, maybe today's the day you hit that subscribe button. Help us get to our next milestone goal of 350 subscribers, of which we are 15 away. So I'm Itepukui, the place to be reviews. I've been here with all the yous. And what I say at the end of every video, if I don't see you, have a great day and pleasant tomorrow.